Hey, YouTubers. So I'm on the patio again. Yes, the patio again. On this Thursday evening right now, I'll be smoking a big ass pipe right now, like a big ass cigar. Smoking my corn cob pipe right now with some Sorolta Raleigh pipe tobacco. Here we go. For the douchebag trolls who are wondering, it is pipe tobacco in my pipe, nothing else. Yeah, pipe tobacco in my pipe, nothing else. So let's fire this bad boy up right now. Damn. Ooh, damn. Damn. There's a car going by in the background. There we go. So I've had a good evening so far. Had a very positive evening. First off, since I checked in with you guys last time, I've had dinner. So for dinner tonight, we had burgers and french fries. Yeah, big ass burgers and big ass french fries. So I made the dinner completely independently. I cooked the french fries. You know, I preheated the oven. Then I put the french fries in. And then I flip them over at 10 and a half minutes. And then I put them back in and I cook them for another 10 and a half minutes. And then I made on the George Foreman grill the burgers. And they were good. Very good, the burgers. Put a slice of American cheese on top. The hell? There's a couple little ants on the table. I hope the ants don't get on my pants. So, yeah, ants in my pants. Get the hell off the table, you little buggers. So, yeah, the burgers were good, and it took about, to make the entire meal, the entire meal from preheating the oven all the way to sitting down and eating. It took about 45 minutes. Yeah, it took about 45 minutes. The fries were the most complicated, the most, you know, time-consuming. Because obviously the fries, you have to cook them for 21 minutes, and that takes time. And yeah, so the burger is pretty easy to cook on the George Foreman grill, so only takes about 5 minutes, 3 to 5 minutes. Depending on the size of the meat, not meat isn't your, you know, your pecker, you know, so meat is in the hamburger patty. So, yeah, so that was a good meal. I enjoyed making that. It's very fun to make. So, I found out that I will be going to the tobacco shop on June 23rd. I'll be going to the tobacco shop. And I'll be seeing my tobacconist on June 23rd and be smoking a couple nice big ass cigars there, as in the big ass cigar for life. Yep. So I'll be going there, going to Dunkin' Donuts first, get my coffee and get my ice water. And then going to the tobacco shop and gonna buy a couple nice big ass cigars there. And you know, enjoy myself, smoke in the lounge and have my lunch probably. There used to be a really good cafe I used to eat there. There used to be a cafe next door where I used to get food, but unfortunately they have nothing gluten-free. It's an Indian place, and they used to have like a chicken panini sandwiches, but unfortunately nothing there is gluten-free. So that really sucks in general. So I just bring a peanut butter sandwich. I bring a peanut butter sandwich. Dog barking in the background, sorry. So yeah, I bring a peanut butter sandwich. And I have my cigars in the lounge. And I smoke, and then I you know, my parents pick me up at after I smoke. And yeah, so I'll have a fun time there. Whew, smoky. Probably get some of that Faneuil Hall tobacco because I'm really looking forward to reviewing that. I hear it's just like Lane 1Q. It's their version of Lane 1Q. So that's good. Smoke my corn cob pipe with some Faneuil Hall. And yeah, very excited to go to the tobacco shop. I'll be requesting off the time. Request time off from work. Use some pay time off, some PTO. Yeah, I'm allowed to do that. Request some pay time off. And yeah, beautiful night outside right now. Just a gorgeous night outside right now. The pool's in the background. Excuse me. Anyway, have a nice night. Bye-bye.